Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. And this is lecture number 9.3 in the Game Theory topic, Module 9, Game Theory. The topic for this lecture is Game Theory. In Game Theory, 2% zero-sum game without saddle point, and we are going to use the graphical method to solve such a problem. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the game without saddle point using graphical method. So, the 2% zero sum game without saddle point. So, here when there is no saddle point, the on the payoff matrix of the game problem, it indicates that the player cannot use the pure strategy for their play. So, when there is saddle point, so we have to search for the saddle point. So, when there is saddle point, the strategies corresponding to the saddle point is the pure strategy for the player A and B. When there is no saddle point, the player, they cannot use the single strategy for the play. They have to apply different strategy at the correct proportion of time to optimize his loss or gain. So, this kind of method is called as mixed strategies method. So, when there is saddle point, the strategy corresponding to the saddle point is the pure strategy, and when there is no saddle point, we have to use the mixed strategy concept. So the technique, steps to solve the problem. First step, we have to confirm that there is no saddle point in the problem. Again, we have to search for the saddle point. We have to confirm that there is no saddle point. Then reduce the matrix using the dominance rule. So there are two dominance rule. Dominance rule for the row. Every value in the dominating row must be greater than or equal to corresponding value of the dominated row. So, when this is identifying the dominated row, we have to delete the dominated row. So, similarly, dominance rule for the column, every value in the dominating column must be less than or equal to the corresponding value in the dominated column. Again, we have to delete the dominated column. Now, if the matrix is step 3, if the matrix is reduced to 2 by 2 matrix, obtain the solution by arithmetic method. If the matrix is reduced step 4, if the matrix is reduced to 3 by 3 matrix, then obtain the solution by the matrix method, approximate method or linear programming method. If the matrix is reduced to 2 by n or m by 2 matrix, use the graphical method to find the optimal strategies and then use the arithmetic method to solve the game. Now, we are going to use the graphical method. So, step number 5, we will be demonstrating with two examples. Example number 6, so we solve the game, 5 by 2 game graphically. So, there are player A has got the 5 strategies, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. Player B has got 2 strategies, B1 and B2. The payoff matrix is minus 2, 5. Minus 2 means, if the player A is playing with the A2, player B is playing with the B1, player A is playing with the A1, player B is playing with the B1, the loss for B1 is minus 2, the gain for A1 is minus 2. That means, player A is losing the money, player B is gaining the money. That is the significance of negative value in the payoff matrix. So, when you have negative value, the corresponding amount will be gained by the player B. So, minus 2, 5, minus 5, 3, 0, minus 2, minus 3, 0, 1, minus 4. These are all the values in the payoff matrix. Now, the solution. First, we have to search for the saddle point. So, in the saddle point, search for the saddle point is given in the table matrix here. Minimum of the row. We have to search for the minimum of the row. So, minus 2, 5, minus 2, minus 5, 3, minus 5, 0, minus 2, minus 2, minus 3, 0, minus 3. 1 minus 4 minus 4. So, these are all the minimum value and the maximum of the column. So, minus 2 minus 5 0 minus 3 1. The maximum value is 1 here and 5 3 minus 2 0 minus 4 5. The maximum value is 5. Then minimum of the row. So, maximum of the minimum. So, this is minus 2. Maximum of the minimum is minimax. Maximin is minus 2 and similarly minimax is minus 5. So, the minimax value is not equal to the maximum value. So, there is no saddle point in the problem. when there is no saddle point in the problem, then we have to try to reduce by dominant rule. So delete A2 and A4 by the dominance rule. So A2 and A4 we have to delete. The value of the row in A1 is greater than values of A2. Also the values are of row A1 are greater than A4. So A1 minus 2, 5. A2 minus 5, 3. So A1 values are the values in the A1 are greater than A2. Similarly, A4 minus 3, 0. Again, value of A1 are greater than value of A4. So if the player A is playing with A2 or A4, his gain will be less. So he should not use the strategies A2 and A4. So whenever he want to use A2 and A4, he has to prefer A1 minus 2, 5. This will give the higher gain. So if the player A is plays with A2 and A4, the gain will be less than playing with A1. So the rows A1 and A4 are deleted. So when you delete, this is the remaining matrix. So the player A will be playing with either A1, A3 or A5. Player B, he has got only two options, B1 and B2. Now among the three strategies for the player A, a further reduction is not possible. So further reduction is not possible. So we are going to use the graphical method to identify the strategies. So reduce the matrix by graphically. So we repeat the matrix again. A1, A3, A5, B1, B2, minus 2, 5, 0, minus 2, 1, minus 4. So these are all the values. Now graphically we have to find out the optimum strategies for the player A, right? Among the three strategies, we have to select only two, best two of the three for player A. So in the graphical method, we take a graph sheet, right? Two vertical line at convenient distance. First vertical line for the player, for the strategy B1, and the second vertical line for the strategy B2 at convenient distance. And we use the graph sheet 1 centimeter equal to 1. So starting from minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we mark the value here. Now strategy A1. So for corresponding values, B1 is minus 2, B2 is 5. So minus 2 and 5. You connect these two points by a line, and this is corresponding to the strategy A1. And A3, 0, minus 2. So for B1, it is going to be 0. For B2, it is going to be minus 2. So 0, minus 2. And this is corresponding to the strategy A3. And A5, 1, minus 4. So A5, 1. And corresponding to B1. And the value here, it is minus 4. 1, minus 4. So for the three strategies. So for as far as player B is concerned, he wants to minimize his losses. So when the player B is playing with B1 and B2, A is playing with either A1, A3 or A5. So the value in the upper portion of the curve, the minimum point corresponding to these two strategies, one is A1, another one is A5. So the among the three strategies, the two strategy which will give minimum loss to the player B, it is going to be A1 and A5, corresponding to this point. So A1 and A5. So when you have B1, B2, so player B is playing with B1, B2, and when the player A is playing with A1 and A5, the loss for the B1 will be minimum. The player B wants to minimize his loss. The strategies are A1 and A5, and the corresponding matrix is minus 2, 5, 1, minus 4. Then we have to find the solution by arithmetic method. So as we said earlier lecture, so minus 2, 5 is 7 is the difference. So remember, so we have to ignore, we have to minus 2, 5. So this is going to be 7 is the difference. So 7 you have to write in the second row. 1 minus 4, the difference is 5. So we have to write in the first row. Right? Do not subtract. We have to find the difference. Then first column, minus 2, 1, 3 is the difference. So we have to write in the second column. 5 minus 4, 9 is the difference. We have to write in the first column. So the sum of the adjuvants, 5 plus 7, 12, 9 plus 3, 12. So the adjuvants are equal. We can solve by arithmetic method. So So the timing are 5 by 12, 7 by 12, and here it is 9 by 12 and 3 by 12. So the value of the game, equal to minus 2 into 5 by 12, minus 2 into 5 by 12 plus 1 into 7 by 12, which is going to be minus 3 by 12. So this is the value. So here in this game, at the end of the game, player B will be gaining the money, gaining the amount by 3 by 12 value. And the strategies for the player A. So he is playing with the A1 and A5. So 5 by 12, 0, 0, 0. A2, he is not using A2, A3, A4 and A5 for the time 7 by 12. And similarly for the player B, the strategies are 9 by 12 and 3 by 12. So this is the answer to the problem. We take another example, solve the following game by the graphical method. So we have 3 strategies for the player A and 2 strategies for the player B. So A1, A2, A3, B1 and B2 and the payoff matrix is minus 2, 4, 8, 3, 9, 0. Now we find the saddle point, we search for the saddle point. So the search for the saddle point matrix is given here and we have to write the minimum of the row. So minus 2, 4, the minimum value is 2, minus 2. 8, 3, minimum value is 3, 9, 0, the minimum value is 0, and we have to write the maximum of the column. So for the B1, minus 2, 8, 9, the maximum is 9, and the B2, 4, 3, 0, the maximum is 4. Now the among the minimum of the row, we have to find the maximum value, the maximum value is 3, among the maximum of the column, we have to find the minimum value is 4, and these two are equal. These two are not equal. So minimax value is not equal to maximum value. So there is no saddle point in the problem. Then we have to reduce the matrix by graphical, reduce matrix by graphical method. Straight away, there are only 3 strategies. We have to reduce by graphical method. So for graphical method, we have to draw the graph. So first vertical line for the strategy B1, at a convenient distance, we draw the second vertical line for the strategy B2. And we take the range of the value from the payoff matrix. So it is minus 2, minimum value is minus 2, maximum value is 9. So we take minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 1 centimeter, we take a graph sheet and mark all the value here. Now we take strategy A1. So strategy A1, the values are for B1 it is minus 2, B2 is 4. So A1. Where is A1? A1 is here, minus 2 and 4. For A2, 8 and 3. So, 8 and 3. For A3, 9 and 0. So, for the player B, so if he is using 2 strategy, his objective is minimizing the losses. The minimum point is here. Minimum point, point of the standard area is here. The corresponding strategies are A1 and A2. So, for the player B wants to minimize his loss, the strategies are A1 and A2 and the corresponding matrix values are minus 2, 4 and 8 and 3. Now we find the, we reduced it to two strategies for the player A. Now we go to the arithmetic method to solve the game. So the matrix is repeated here again. So A1, the difference is minus 2, 4 is 6 is the difference. We write the 6 in the second row. For the second row, 8, 3, the difference is 5. We write in the first row for the vertical column, B1 column, minus 2, 8, the difference is 10. So, we write in the second column, 4, 3, the difference is 4, 3, 1, 1. We write the difference here, 1 in the first column. The sum of the oddment, 1 plus 10 is 11, 5 plus 6 is 11. So, the sum of the oddments are equal. So, we can solve it by arithmetic method. So, the timing for A1 is 5 by 11, timing for A2 is 6 by 11, and the timing for B1 is 1 by 11, and the timing for B2 is 10 by 11. So, the value of the game, it is going to be, when used for the player B1, so minus 2 into 5 by 11 plus 8 into 6 by 11, it is going to be 38 by 11, and the value strategies for the player A, among the 3 strategies, he is using only 1 and 2. So, 5 by 11 and 6 by 11, third strategy is not at all using. And for player B, he is using the first strategy for the 1 by 11 time and the second strategy for 10 by 11 time. So, these are all the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Operation Research for further information. We continue with the graphical method in the next lecture also. We take two more problems in the graphical method in the next lecture. I upload the video lecture of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in the next lecture. Until then, bye.